What's up, guys? On today's video, we're going to be mocking up the fuel system in the Tool Drive K5 build. All the parts I'll be using, I'll link them down in the description. So if you want to run your fuel system this way, it'll be easy for you to find the parts. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, click the box in the bottom right-hand corner. Turn on your notifications so you never miss a video.
When you've gotten what you want.
All right, guys, we got the fuel tank at least mocked up for now. The part number is GM15C. That will be for a 1987 25 gallon Blazer tank. It has the fuel tray built in for TBI. Can't really see it, but it'll help with us running that Holley Sniper. So if we have any fuel slosh, hopefully there'll be some in the tray and keep it from getting starved at the pump. I don't have the part numbers for the fuel tank straps. I bought them previously. I was going to run a 25 gallon tank in the 83 C10, but I never did. So those were just residuals. I'm sure any 25 gallon tank straps for the Blazers will work from 73 to 87. So we're about to put in the sending unit. Just kind of set it in there for now. It don't have to be perfect. We're going to run our AN adapter fittings on it so we can start running our lines and get our Corvette filter regulator mounted where we're going to do it so we can start building hard lines. We're going to knock that out real quick and we'll come back.
You got what you want, baby, I should start all over.
Okay, guys, we got our fuel sending unit in. We got our AN adapters that are, they convert it from dash six to metric thread so we can run some flex lines. We'll run the flex lines out of the tank down this little bracket right here, and then we'll connect into our hard lines on the driver's side frame rail. We just got to find a spot to mount our Corvette filter regulator. And we got this nifty little bracket just off Amazon, so we can get it bolted up where we need it. We got our feed line, we got our feed and return. The Corvette filter regulator, it's also a built-in return line, so you only have to run one feed to the engine or throttle body like I'll be using. Top one's our feed, bottom one's our return, and it regulates pressure at 58 PSI. We'll mount it on the driver's side frame rail, and then we'll get our hard lines bent where we want them and get everything mocked up. So I'm gonna get these at least one flex line ran where I want it and get it mounted up so we can mount the regulator and get started from there. I'll be right back with you guys. We'll just be running flex line with these dash six fittings. We'll probably run a little more flex line than I want to get to the frame rail, but it'll be all right. It's no more than 5 foot, so we'll be pretty good there. We'll just run one. I don't have enough flex line to build both, so we'll just build one for the feed line, and then we can order some more and we can get started from this. So basically, this is how our flex lines will be ran. We're just going to run it through the frame rail, down this tank mounting bracket, back to the other side frame rail. We'll get those mounted with some rubber grommets and everything so the hoses aren't rubbing against nothing. Nothing's loose getting out of the way where it could somehow get caught in a drive shaft or pinched with the suspension or something like that. So we'll get it all mounted up. Right now we're going to get the filter mounted where we want it, and we'll start building hard lines. All right, guys, I think we found a spot inside the frame rail. We're gonna mount it. So we'll just use some stainless little bolts to get it mounted to where we want it. And then we'll start building our hard lines down the frame rail to connect into the throttle body and down the frame rail to connect into the soft lines coming out of the fuel tank. All right, guys, that's where we're gonna be mounting the filter inside the frame rail. So basically, we will just have to build our hard lines going all the way up this frame rail. Probably pop it out right about where the shock would come up. We'll angle it out so we can run a flex line from there to the throttle body. And then we also run one down this frame rail to connect into our soft line that comes out right in front of the axle a little bit. So we're gonna start building our hard lines that'll go from our flex line to the filter, but at first we need to get this mounted with some rubber grommets and everything so it's in place so we know how long we need to build our hard lines. So to secure the line, we'll just be using these little clamps that are got a little rubber gasket on the inside to keep it from cutting the line up. That's what we secured all of our brake lines with. A little smaller size than this one, so we're gonna secure our flex line so that way it's not rubbing on the frame, anything like that, rubbing a hole in our soft line, so we don't have any issues there. We're gonna knock this out and then we'll start building our hard lines. We'll be right back. Okay, guys, I left some slack in the bracket so I can move the hose around to where I need it. We've got a little bit of slack to take out, and then we'll start building the hard lines. We'll be using 3/8 stainless to do the hard lines in. This is just a piece I was messing with the hose bending pliers, or the tubing bending pliers I bought. I actually had a cheap set, I ended up breaking them trying to bend the stainless. So I called the old Snap-on man and bought a pair of Blue Point, and they seem to work just fine. I'm actually able to bend 90 without kinking the stainless, when I wasn't even able to bend a 45 without kinking the other one. So we're gonna get to building some hard lines. We're gonna connect our soft lines to the fuel filter feed and return first. Then we will start working on the feed line to the throttle body. So we're just gonna run down basically from the C-notch to the bracket to the filter right there. Then from the filter to probably that shock mount right about there with hard lines. Should be pretty simple. These two will be identical. We'll get them grommeted in as well so they're not rubbing against nothing, and do the same there. So I'm gonna get to building these hard lines and we'll come back. All right, guys, this is the system I came up with so far for the filter, feeder, and return to our soft lines. I've test fitted a couple times, seems to fit very well, so we're gonna get that bolted in, get it screwed onto the filter, get our flex line hooked up. I still got to order some more flex line to build the return line, but same length, same bends, should fit perfect, and then we'll start working on the feed line. All right, guys, this will be the hard line that'll run from the feed of the fuel filter to the back of the throttle body. Well, outside the frame rail anyways. It's gonna set in like this, and this angle right here will just kind of kick us off towards the throttle body. We'll build a flex line for it, and then we should be good to go to get the motor and trans set in. We might have to do a slight modification once we get both of those in there, but as of right now, this is what we got planned. I'll get it bolted in, kind of get it mocked up how we want it, and I'll come back and show you the end result. All right, guys, the top one will be our feed. Runs down the driver's side frame rail. Connects into the bracket, or connects into the filter, sorry. And then our hard line will run down the frame rail. It's tucked up at the very top. I don't know if you can see that or not. And then it will pop out just right in front of the shock mounting stud. And we'll run a flex line from here, connecting into the throttle body, which we can cap off and make it returnless, since we'll have a return at the filter down the rail to the tank, saving us a lot of hard line running a full return. Should come out pretty clean. I'll do a little quick video of making the flex line. We'll probably do about a foot and a half. We'll have to use a 45 fitting from the back of the throttle body, or which would be the back of the throttle body. That one will be a straight fitting. So this is where I keep all my little AN fittings. Basically, I'll just use a straight on one end and then a 45 on the other. Now, this end will connect to the throttle body. Some of y'all may not like the way I build my hoses, but I've always built them this way, never had any issues. Like I said, this isn't really how you should do it, but this is the way I'm going to do it. So if you build yours this way, just note I'm not reliable if they start leaking, which they might, but mine haven't. So I'll do a little demonstration of how I build my hoses. We'll cut this one to about a foot and a half, maybe 2 foot, depending on what they look like. I think these are actually 2 foot. These are pre-built at Jegs. I just got them whenever they were real cheap. Sometimes I have sales on them, but these are all Russell brand fittings, so they're good quality. Earl's is a good quality as well. We ran some Earl's, some Russell. Jegs seems to be a decent quality ones. I wouldn't recommend getting these cheapos off of Amazon, which I built my transmission lines out of the cheapos on the black pickup. Haven't had any issues yet, but good quality fittings would be best. So Russell brand, these are all Russell Earls. This side connects to hard lines. This one connects to hoses. So We're going to start building our hose for our throttle body, and we'll come back. So what I like to do is just get some real tight electrical tape, just a couple of wraps. You don't want it too thick, otherwise you'll never get your fitting on. Now this is the area some of y'all may not like. I'm just going to use these cutters. I'm going to cut it straight in the middle, get it as straight as I can, and then I'm going to build my fitting. Makes a pretty clean cut, as you can see. Then we'll start building our, I've already put the straight end on. I did that off camera, and I'll show you the way I'll do my 45. So the way these AN fittings work is basically this slides over the end of the hose. It's threaded, and this will thread down into the center of the hose, making it like a little compression fit. You'll also kind of thread it so you can thread it onto the hose as well. I'll get it started off camera and we'll finish it. So you just kind of thread it on there. And once it gets close, you can just finish pressing it on till it's kind of hard to see in there. But the hose should be flush with the bottom of the fitting. Then you just, I like to use a little ATF. I already kind of put a little on the end. And then just start threading your fitting in. While you kind of want to try to hold it down, make sure it doesn't move off, like become unflush anymore. But there'll be a point you won't be able to do it by hand. Right about there, you just grab your wrenches. It's best if you have like an aluminum crescent, which I don't. That's kind of why I went with these raw fittings. This one's actually bigger than the last one. Need just a little bit more so we can get it off there. And that is how we built our AN lines. Like I said, it's not the recommended way to build them, but that's the way I built it. So basically, this flex line will connect right here. Then it should run up the firewall where we can mount it into the back of our throttle body, just like that. Cap off the return sign of the throttle body. And that is how we will be feeding the LS engine with fuel injection. We'll be running an AC Delco EP381 pump. That's out of, it should fit in the hangar, no problem. That, I think that's out of like a 97, 98, 96, somewhere around there. Just Chevy truck. They ran the higher fuel, the higher PSI on the TBI. So that'll provide the 58 we need. The Corvette regulator will make sure it stays at 58 PSI and returns any of the fuel back to the tank that we won't need. So pretty simple fuel system. Relatively cheap versus, I think, from inline two, buying the old style, like TBI lines in stainless were, $100 a piece per line. So actually $165 per line. So we would have well over probably $400 in everything by the time we got it here. So that's just what you can run the TBI lines if you want to do that, TBI pump, or TBI pump, TBI filter, and then you can have everything factory. Factory runs down the passenger side frame rail, but I wouldn't have any room for the Corvette filter regulator on the passenger with the brake lines there. So that is why we went on the driver's side. I chose to build everything myself because I got 40 foot of stainless for $40. So I probably have under $150 in this fuel system as far as the lines, fittings, filter, everything. With tank, I got the tank on Amazon for, it was a return. The box was damaged, tank was not, so it was $40 for that. Another 60 for this. So I probably have around $250 in this entire fuel system, which will feed an LS or the Holley Sniper at 58 PSI. So that's our fuel system. If you enjoyed the video, click the box in the bottom right-hand corner to subscribe to the channel. Like if you don't mind, comment, tell me where you're from, and we'll catch you on the next one, guys.